only places you'll be able to see is on these monitors.
Well, I'll just stand out there with them.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you just stand in front of them and just refer back.
It'll never matter, as long as you're talking to the microphone.
Yeah, because that monitor.
I gotta do that?
Yeah, yes. And if they ask questions, you gotta do that.
Okay, so that's the only way it's gonna record.
Right.
So, but if you're gonna go identify something up there, I'll just wait for you to look at it, go to another slide, and then go back and read.
So.
I'll just click on it here.
You can just do page up, page down.
Okay.
Well, the thing you wanna do is you wanna put the show on here, right?
Well, I don't want it to go by itself because then, is that how you do?
Yeah, so if you're present, if I was presenting here, I would see the next.
Oh, and I would just go next here.
Yeah, you could just hit next.
Okay.
I hope it works.
I do too.
But by keeping it in, well, there's another way of doing it. Well, this is set up like this because of that cable.
Boy, I hope.
This is it printed out, right?
It is printed out, if you wanna walk with it.
You can walk with that.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, ready to go on live, ready to go live?
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for taking time out of your evening tonight to come spend time with us at City Hall to go over our project that we have here at SOM in Aurora. It's the SOM and Aurora intersection improvements. Some of the things that the city's gonna be doing is widening the intersection, adding some turning lanes, some sewer replacement, storm and sanitary, all in an effort to help increase and improve traffic through the center of town and 9143 corridor. I'd like to start with some introductions tonight for some people that are here. Starting with myself, my name is Bill Dursick. I'm the Public Works Commissioner. Sitting in the front row over here, we have Dan Driscoll. He's our Construction Project Administrator. We have John Bush. He's the City Engineer. I should have done the mayor first. That's my fault.
Hi, everybody.
He's wore out from the last meeting. Mr. Schimmitz, Councilman. Mrs. Meany here, Councilperson. Am I missing any other council people? I got Mr. Tom Bandiera back here. He's our Service Director. Matt DeSanto here is from GPI. He's our Contract Project Administrator. I'm gonna be turning the program over to him shortly. But again, this is an effort to make sure that we're increasing traffic through the city and to replace some storm and sanitary sewers that are much needed updating. So with that being said, I'm gonna turn it over to Matt. Oh, I'm sorry, did I miss Doug? Is Doug in here? Doug Hendrick, he's also from GPI. And the main inspector on the job is Denver Kyler. Hope I pronounced that right. And from Katz Construction, I got Mike Dempsey standing back there. He's the owner of Katz. So, thank you.
Good evening, everybody. All right, so I'm gonna run through the project, kind of give you a quick overview so you know what's gonna happen. So there's no surprises, and we could try to accommodate everybody's needs. How many people here are business owners? Good part. And residents? A few residents? Okay. All right, so. Do we have the PowerPoint going? Oh, there
yes.
It is. Okay. So, quick overview. This is the SOM Center Aurora Road Intersection Improvement Project. We have some graphics up here. I don't know if you get a chance to look at them yet, but right off the bat, we have a before and after right here. The general scope of work on the project. The intent is to add lanes going northbound and southbound so that we have two left turn lanes in those directions on some. And on Aurora Road, we're gonna have a right turn lane that's gonna be added. All right, so that's gonna increase the capacity of the road, and the way John describes it to me is he'll be able to change the cycling on the signal so that the phasing is more efficient, I guess is the best way to explain it. To add these lanes, we're gonna do pavement widening, asphalt resurfacing, traffic signal replacement, storm sewer replacements, sanitary sewer replacement. This underground work is an improvement, and that's something we're going to get, and you want to get done when you're doing these kinds of major renovations to any kind of road. All right. We're going to extend water service and hydrants and restore all disturbed areas on the project, clean it up, make it pretty when we're done. You could go to the next slide, Marcy. Sequence of work. Right off the bat, Katz has given us a preliminary schedule. He'll be working at day hours right off the bat, and we'll be working on water line extensions, on hydrants, and water service. That's going to be a short duration effort, maybe a week, 2 weeks at the most. Then we're going to get into underground sewer work. The storm and sanitary sewers are going to basically be in four quadrants. We're going to start west of Somme, between Solon Boulevard and Somme. That short little stretch is going to basically be closed at night. All right, we'll get more into that. As we progress through the job, it's going to be, we're going to move to 43 east of Somme. Yeah, go ahead. We're talking about like 9 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Okay. Thank
you. Okay. And we'll get into more of the hours and the accommodations and everything. So basic sequence with the underground work for the sewers is 43 west of Somme, then moving to the east side of Somme Center, and then going to the north quadrant on Somme Center Road, and then Somme south of 43. So as I said, the traffic maintenance. Right off the bat with the waterworks, day work. Then we're going to go to night work. Primarily night work. I don't know if we Mike might get some things done during the day. Any MOT during the day would be short distance closures on lanes, but yeah, with flaggers. It's no major zones that are being set up or anything like that. Hmm? Oh, okay. Yeah, MOT is short for maintenance of traffic. It's kind of like an industry jargon that we throw around. That's it. So the detour at night will basically be from 9 p.m. to 6 a.m., as I said. This graphic right here on the left pretty much shows a detour that we're going to have set up. Going up to Bainbridge Road, going down Solon Road, and getting back to Aurora.
So mainly Aurora is going to be closed.
Right. And our intent is to keep access.
Could be maintained with local traffic. So close.
Right. That's what I was just getting to.
Well, so they'll maintain traffic as best they can. They'll have law officers out there, you know, for both the safety of the workers and the traveling public. Okay.
Thank you.
Sorry about that. I'm new with the mic. Okay. And as we progress through the job, things are going to change. So once we're past this detour thing, then, you know, we'll be advising everybody about how things are going to change the job. The question was, will there be periods of time without water?
No.
No. No. Hopefully not.
Unless there's an issue when we go to
I'm sorry. Unless there's an issue with the taps, there we should have water at all times, and if we are going to affect the water, we'll try. We'll talk to the businesses and residents and try to work with you guys doing in your off or non-peak times.
I guess we can ask what business and where, and so we can, you know, we'll make sure we keep you guys in the loop as to when we're going to do it.
Right on the corner of the Imperial Walk, 91 and 43.
Okay.
So there's no boiler alerts or anything. They're, the type of taps we're doing are just small, quick taps. And we're not doing any cutting valves. We're not doing any water main work. These are just extensions, copper. So nothing major.
I would add to that, though, there might be some periods of some cloudy water, and just because there is over the years, water lines tend to get a little bit of sediment built up in the bottom of them. So any disruption to any line may cause some of that built-in sediment to get kicked up. So there may be some periods of cloudy water and around the time that the contractor's working on those water lines. So if you do see that, you just let it run a little bit longer, and it will clear out.
So getting back to the sequence of work, as we get out of the sewer work and the underground work, we'll continue with pavement improvements, decorative lighting, new signs, new traffic signals, and final lawn restoration. Those are pretty much the surface treatments and beautification of the intersection. Okay. So this is speaking more to all the issues that businesses are going to be concerned about. We're going to be looking to increase communication between everybody, make sure that everyone's needs are being met. When something's being done in the general area, we'll be delivering letters, bulletins, basically handouts to everybody. Business owners, if it's affecting your business uniquely, we'll be talking to you. So,
excuse me, what kind of time frame are you talking about? Less than 3 days?
The time frame will be letting you know probably 20, 48 hours, a couple days before things are happening. You know. One thing we're going to do is request information from y'all. So if you have any special needs, deliveries, maybe you have night deliveries while we're doing night work, for instance. We'd like to know about that so that we could accommodate you. Water for restaurants is important, things like that. So, but mainly it's access issues, I think, especially when we have the detour in place. We want to make sure people can get where they want to go. Yeah, so the sewer work, this initial phase, is going to be about 2 months.
Okay. So is that detour going to be posted to discourage through traffic the entire time through November, or just?
No, it's up and down every night.
Okay.
Yeah.
But during the day, it'll all be blocked off.
Yeah. The day, everything's going to be, everything will be restored. Yeah.
So through traffic will be allowed during the day.
Yeah. The way the plans were set up contractually is CATS has to do work and restore it and allow traffic to be back on the road.
Okay.
So
there's future phases where work is actually going on down the center of the road on 91. So those phases of traffic will be done with basically a short zone that's on the road that allow traffic to flow past it. So I think I'm loud enough.
Right.
So Don, you want to come up here?
Oh, I'm sorry.
So what Doug's saying is when they're work.
I'm sorry, I can't keep my mouth shut. I'm sorry, but as Matt was saying, the zone for the detour is only going to be up during that time frame that the work needs to be done on 43. It's pretty intrusive in the middle of the road. It allows cats to get in and get out of that sequence much quicker. There's future phases where storm sewer work and sanitary work actually has to cut diagonally across the intersection of 91 and 43. That work will be done at night. That's where we'll actually do that work at night, button it up, close the pavement up. You'll be able to access that completely zone free the next day by 7 o'clock. So they'll continue to do those short-term nighttime operations through the duration of the project. There may be times that, you know, they're working in an area that's got a driveway that's closed off on one side. They'll make sure we got access through another driveway or, you know, partial with work on that. So they'll always make sure that you've got access to your business as well.
And that's only for the first 2 months? Or that's for the duration of the whole project?
Well, that's for the duration of the project, but it's going to be, in, as Matt has said, there's quadrants. So the work will be done on 43 in front of, if I assume you have a business on 43?
43 and 91.
Okay, so that work will be done at some point in time, and they'll be pretty much gone while they go and do work on 91 on the south side, 91 on the north side, and 43 on the east side. Once all that work is done for the underground utilities, subsequent to that, they'll come back and they'll do the widening. So there'll be another, maybe another period in time where they'll come back in front of your business to widen that street out, put the curbs in and the sidewalks, where there may be another small partial impact to your work or to your business. But that, again, will be coordinated so there's always access in and out of your operation. Okay.
Basically, the plans were set up to minimize impacts to traffic. And that's the most for the daytime hours. So.
The reason I ask all these questions because what happened in Mayfield, a lot of people lost their businesses because they couldn't keep up making payments because.
Mayfield Road on Mayfield in Road. Mayfield Heights?
Yeah.
I'm familiar with that project. That was a full zone that they set up during the day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's not similar to this in that regard.
Okay. You promise?
Well, we'll keep people moving in and out.
That is why this. That's why the city awarded an alternate to pay the contractor extra money to work at night, so that we wouldn't be affecting businesses during the day, and much of the work that could be done in the nighttime will be done in the nighttime, and the road will be as open as much as possible during the daytime.
And that's the main difference between those projects. You have projects that are active all day long, even at night hours, and they have a permanent zone with reduced lanes. This project we're doing is gonna be mostly, at least the underground work, is gonna be done at night, and it's going to be open wide for traffic during the day.
Okay.
So
there's no detour set for SOM then when it goes at night?
No, it'll be flagged. Traffic will be maintained at night on SOM. The traffic flows are a little higher, and there's not a good detour to set up that for that route.
Yeah.
We got to follow the rules with detours. Yeah, public services. So this is worth saying, public safety. We're emergency access will always be maintained. Police, fire, the city will notify emergency services at all times of any situations that we have with traffic on the job. On Baldwin Road, I think, is the road that's affected most with the project. They're gonna maintain trash and recycling as usual. And any needed changes to school bus schedules or where they're picking up and anything, they're gonna, I guess the school board will arrange for that, right? But everyone will be notified. Okay, pre-construction photographs. This is a video that the contractor does. So, at one point, Baldwin's going to be closed during the project. At SOM. So that was. Okay, that's the road. If you're not familiar, it's the road just south of Aurora Road.
Hmm?
So pre-construction videos are done to protect contractor, businesses, residents as to the condition of the existing property. When we go in to finally restore everything, we want to make sure that nothing was negatively impacted by our activities. So we'll have that proof to make sure everything is done properly. And it benefits everybody. Okay, planned utility interruptions. We're getting back to the kind of we jumped dropped in early with the water. One of the requirements of doing underground work is having OOPS, the Ohio Utility Protection Services, come out and flag everything, all the underground utilities. Please do not move any of these flags if you see them. They're very important. They're protected by state law, and the contractor needs them to perform their work properly. When they don't know where something is, you stand the chance of accidentally breaking it. So that could be cable, electric, water, any underground utilities. So the planned utility interruptions, as we previously talked about, is just going to be maybe short-term, very short duration water turnoffs, if at all. And it's limited to just certain properties, I think. So that's the planned utility interruptions. Everything will be notified in advance. Unplanned utility interruptions occur when something isn't where it's supposed to be and we end up breaking it. It happens. We try to avoid this at all costs. It's expensive to the contractor. It's expensive to the utilities. But sometimes it just happens. So if something happens where you lose any utility, whether it's electric or cable or whatever, bear in mind that this is something we don't want. No one wants to happen. And the services, they're considered an emergency, and they restore them as fast as possible. So, so if you have immediate concerns on the job, there are people that will be out there to talk to. CATS has a superintendent that will be on the job at all times, a management person. Right now that's Ron Parker, and his phone number is up there, and we could probably, that'll be on a letter when we put that out. And construction department here in the city of Solon is published and online for everyone. And our company GPI will be performing project management, and we'll be on the project. I'll be on the project, or other representatives.
And just to repeat the phone numbers for CATS, Ron Parker's number is 440-799-5208, and the City of Solon Construction Department is 440-337-1344.
That's our little summary. We just want to introduce the project to everybody, and we'd like to continue the dialogue, even if it's a one-on-one, or if anyone has anything they'd like to share with everybody right now, or we can mingle and look at the graphics and talk about things on everybody's personal issues they might have in their location.
As far as utilities go, you're not going to move any poles, are you? There's no poles to move, like electric poles or anything?
The poles were already moved as ahead of the project.
The traffic signals will be relocated.
So like utility poles, like electric or anything?
Not that. That's a pre-phase work that we did.
Footage we're going to lose on the corner of 91 and 43?
Which corner?
The where the Imperial Walk is. It's
northwest.
Northwest corner. Now that.
All of the widening on SOM Center will take place on the east side of SOM Center. There will be no widening on the west side.
Yeah. And on Aurora, it's just the northeast corner, right?
And on Aurora, the widening will be primarily between, everybody kind of refers to it as the Pizza Hut driveway. And
soon to be Wendy.
And the intersection right in front of Chase Bank, we're going to add. We're widening, moving the, adding a lane to move the right turn lane over, so we'll have two through lanes going westbound on Aurora. Currently, there's only one, so that'll be the other widening. And the widening on SOM will be from the railroad tracks south, through the intersection, and it'll terminate at Linden. That's where it'll end. at Linden, right at the traffic signal.
Everybody else does.
I can be louder if you want me to, but I'm being nice.
No, the question was from George, how is it Aurora Road going to be impacted? How many lanes were going to stay open
during the day
to make sure that his business or any of the businesses in that shopping plaza are going to be have accessibility?
And Mike, you can chime in. The reason why the city approved the night work was to minimize, to try to at best minimize impact to the businesses during the day.
Okay.
There, like we had said, there will be some work that'll take place during the day in preparation of this, but I don't think at any one time they'll take more than one lane, and that'll be kind of like a local zone in either direction. At no time during the day will there be a full closure of Aurora Road.
I'm just asking for the inconvenience for the people. Is it going to be one lane only, two lanes, three lanes, whatever? Like right now, you got four lanes coming from that area.
I would expect that worst will have one lane in each direction at one time, and that would be worst case scenario. I don't know that that the contractor would even probably do that, but it is a possibility. That's, like I said, that's the main reason why we're doing the night work, to try to do a lot of the utility work at night. I mean, I won't mince words. The utility work we're doing on that stretch of Aurora Road is extensive, and it's going to be impactful. It is necessary. The utilities are old and aged. In my opinion, it wouldn't make good sense on the part of the city to spend all this good money on the surface without addressing the utilities underneath, and that's why we're doing this work.
And the other, the only time that will really change is when we get in there to do full width final paving, when they're putting the asphalt down, you know. But that's a very short duration operation.
That's the last.
Things when, you know.
And Matt talked about the restoration. When we're done, all of the curbs on that stretch of Aurora will be new. All the sidewalks will be new. The road will be resurfaced. It'll be a vast improvement of what is there right now.
Does anyone else have any questions they want to throw out there?
I have some. The city has some sign-in sheets. If you didn't have a chance to sign in tonight before you had a seat, we'd appreciate it if you could give us your contact information. The city wants to be as open as we can with communications, and maybe Matt, you could talk about some of the site website stuff that we're setting up before we leave tonight. We'd appreciate if you could get the communication or your contact information and leave it with us tonight. If you know some other businesses that aren't here tonight, please pass the word along and have them contact us, because the best thing for us to have a successful project this year is communication, and we can't communicate if we don't have the information.
Yeah, if we can follow up on what John said too, so we make sure we have a good point of contact. A lot of you run your business, we're not sure if you're there all the time. So if we've got notifications that are coming out 24 hours ahead of time, we want to make sure we get them to you, the owner, instead of taking them up to a clerk or somebody that's at the desk or at your place of business. The other thing I want to add before Matt goes into the website information is, if you guys have a problem in the field and you see Denver or another GPI inspector out there, and they'll be clearly marked, grab that person and make sure you get a hold of them and let them know immediately what the problem is. We can correct it quicker in the field by talking to the contractor directly than you getting upset, going back into the office, calling the city turn around, trying to figure out where it's at, turn around and call us. We want that direct contact with our people. If you see your driveway blocked or some issue out there, get a hold of our person right away in the field. Let us know what the issue is so we can correct it as quickly as possible. Okay? Matt?
Okay. And the website was brought up. We're going to have a link on the City of Solon's website to a another site that we're going to put a weekly update on. The intent is that we could just give a general overview of how traffic will be impacted as we progress through the project. So hopefully that'll be helpful for everybody. It's not up and running yet, but stay tuned.
Last question, when is it going to start? Tomorrow is, I mean, tomorrow is Friday, is it Monday? Supposed to be in March, right?
Well, we're working on, we're finalizing some paperwork with ODOT. As soon as that work is final or paperwork is finalized, we'll issue the contractor their notice to proceed. They are doing some preparation work to get started, but the first thing, and I would anticipate you'll see some more activity probably as early as next week.
Can you wait till after St. Patty's Day?
We're just going to paint the roads green. That's all they're doing.
Green pizza.
Green, yes.
Green peppers.
Mike, are you planning any weekend work?
Not unless we have to.
Not unless they have to.
Unless there's an issue, we have to.
And that would be communicated well ahead of time. Say, they have to notify us, especially on a Sunday, if they're going to work. There's ordinances in place.
If it's going to be weekend work, it would more be a Friday night into Saturday cave or something like that. Along those lines, which, but other than that, no.
Does anybody else have any other questions that they like? A couple things I'd like to point out. First of all, I want to thank Marcy, Dan, and Laura for putting together this PowerPoint presentation. Brought it together in a short time, so thank you very much. I appreciate all the work you did for that. And again, a couple things to reiterate. The limits of the project, so it's going to be going from Solon Boulevard on 43 down to basically the Burger King light. And on 91 from the bridge down to the traffic light at Linden and the entrance to the shopping center. Communication is important. We want to make sure that we're working with all of the businesses, making sure that you guys are getting what you need. So just like Doug said, if you have an issue, grab a GPI guy. They will be marked. They'll have their yellow and, you know, class 3 reflective vests on. So grab a hold of one of those guys. Contact the city. We want to do everything that we can to make sure this, it's construction, so there's definitely impacts to everybody. We want to make sure it runs as smoothly as possible. And lastly, like John said, there's sign-up sheets here. Please write down your contact information for us. If you know anybody, have them either email the city, call the city, so we can get this list together and make sure everything runs smoothly. Yes, sir.
I am glad to see this project moving along. I have worked hand in hand with John and the engineering department and the mayor doing all the prints over here. And this is the, it's great to see this moving along, you know, and everything else there. So with that, so it's great. I'm a businessman in Solon, right next to your construction company, everything else there. So anything you need, I'm here to help.
If nobody else has anything else, we'll conclude this. Thank you again for coming out tonight. I appreciate you taking your time. Again, I want to thank Mike from CATS for coming out, our GPI people, Denver, Mike and Doug, and all the city staff here. Thank you very much.